Hello there, welcome to DevScope's YouTube channel. In this short video, I'm going to share some tips that improve and diversify the usage of the KPI card. Let's begin with a quick overview of the underlying data for today's case study. There is a small company that wants to track its sales, both in volume and individual instances of sales. Additionally, whenever 100 or more units of products are sold in a single sale, it is called a big sale. The KPI card can be used for many different things, and it usually takes three inputs: the value to be monitored, the trend axis, and the target value. In this case, the company wants to track the percentage of big sales over time, setting a target value of 0.015%. As we can see, this target was achieved for 2016. Nevertheless, the KPI card can be used for many more different cases. This client also wants to study how the volume of sales varied from year to year. Many times, to show both the sales of 1 year and the variation year over year, two cards are overlapped, one for each measure. As we can see in these two cards overlap. In this situation, the KPI card also comes in handy. So, we can achieve that by having the sales amount and the sales amount of the previous year as a target, and in the trend axis we have the year. So, we have the same aspect of the previous two cards overlap. We are going to format this one first by taking out the icons, and then we come to trend axis, and we, in this case, we do not want sentiment colors, so we are going to put all the colors in black. And finally, disable the trend axis as we do not want to see the graphic behind the numbers. To finalize, we only want to see the distance to goal and not the target label, so we are going to disable it. And there we have it. We have the same aspect of the two cards overlapped, just once with one single KPI card. The company also wants to analyze the volume of big sales and the percentage of total sales it represents. Instead of using two overlapped cards, we can also use the KPI card. However, in this scenario, a problem surges. The target label shows distance to goal instead of percentage of total. To solve this, the percentage itself is used as a target and the distance to goal is hidden. As we can see on this card, right now we have the sales B quantity compared to total sales year over year. We are going to take the sales out and put the percentage of big sales. And right now the distance to goal is completely irrelevant, so we are going to hide that. We come here to target label, we are going to hide the distance to goal, and we are going to change the label of the target label to percentage of total to represent the percentage of total of big sales. All these visuals have one thing in common: using a temporal unit as a trend. However, in some cases, we want to dynamically modify the time window of the analysis at a page or report level instead of forcing it in each visual. This can be achieved by introducing a dummy column. For this, I have created a column in the fact table. I usually recommend doing this in the calendar table as it will be applied to all the fact tables, but I have done it in the fact table where each record has the value of 1. Therefore, when calculating, the KPI card will not filter the values based on a time window unless forced by a page or report level filter. As we have right here, we can see that the values sum up to the aggregate of all the years, and then we can later filter them out in the filter pane. Notice that this only applies to things like percentage of total and not comparisons year over year, where there needs to be a valid trend axis to compare it to the previous value. So this is it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos like this one.